Last week, I was at a wedding ceremony of one of my friends. When I returned home, I noticed that I forgot to collect my home key from my room at the hotel. It was a pathetic situation that I didn't even have a spare key to enter my home. Taking this as a learning, I was thinking of ways to ensure that I don't end up in a similar situation hereafter. The best way is to find a way to duplicate the key. Rest assured, I am sure we can do this using 3D printing and with just a photo of the key. To use the Fusion 360 software to duplicate the key. I have already taken multiple photos of the top and side views of the key. We will have to import these photos into the Fusion 360 software. For our requirement, it's enough if we have the top and side views of the key. This is our workspace, which highlights the X, Y, and Z planes. Let's select the plane pertaining to the top view and just import the top side view of this photo. Let's go to Insert and select the top side photo. This photo is not yet calibrated. We don't know the exact dimensions of the photo yet. Only when we mark the two reference points and give the information on the dimensions to the Fusion 360 will it automatically apply the dimensions. I'm going to measure the length of the key using a vernier caliper. If we feed this measured value in millimeters to the Fusion 360's calibrate option, the software will apply the length of the key. Keeping the white line in the background as the reference, we will feed the dimensions at the top and bottom of the key. It's at 56.5 millimeters. Fusion 360 would have applied this length to change the dimensions of the picture internally. Let's now convert this picture into a 3D mesh. We will draw the outline accordingly. In order to draw the outline of the key, including the curves, we can use the curve features of Fusion 360. But we will not need pinpoint precision. Since the 3D print resolution is less, we can just draw the outlines using lines. So let's connect each of these lines. The outline is now drawn. This is now in two dimensions. Since we need to do some changes in the side view, I am selecting the side plane to fit the side view photos to calibrate it. I am going to use a vernier caliper to calculate its dimensions and give this as an input to the Fusion 360 and make the adjustments accordingly. We need to tilt the side view a little. So we will rotate this slightly and straighten it. We will now mark the cuts on this. Only then would we be able to draw the outline and cut it. But we now need to align the side and top views correctly. This will help us to cut the outlines perfectly. In order to get the alignment right, I will be using the V shape at the end of the key as the reference for both the pictures. First, we will align the top side near the margin. At the same position, we will align this to the V cut. Both the pictures are now aligned. We now need to extrude this. I'm going to extrude from the side view. This has now become a 3D mesh. We now need to extrude the top view in a similar way. For this, I'm going to select the intersection and extrude. With this option, we can cut only the portion that we need. Some portions are missing from the key's side view. We will draw outlines for this separately and extrude it. We still don't have the head for this. If we need a head, we have to open a separate cylinder and draw the head portion and extrude it. Alright, we now have a key that still needs several small tinkering to make it complete. But still, let's print this version and check if it works properly. To 3D print this, I'm going to slice it by importing it into the Cura software. We'll now convert this into a G code and export it. Let's now print this. The printing is done. I think the key has come out very well. The key feels like it can be broken easily, but let's put this into a lock and see if it works well. Wow, that's cool. This works great. The key feels like it can be bent a little, but it still serves a purpose and works perfect. I'm going to open and close multiple times and check if it works. Absolutely no issues. It works like a charm. Hey, did you think I just taught you how to make a duplicate key for my home? No doubt. I trust that you'll not misuse it. But don't worry, this was not the duplicate key to my house. This was some other key used for demonstration purposes. Thanks for watching this video. See you again.